Hi guys, my name is Kentrell, and basically today I want to talk about an hourglass tummy tuck and how I came to the conclusion that this is something that I wanted to do for myself. First, I want to say it took a while. I contemplated with the idea probably about a year ago, but I sat down with my husband and we decided that we were going to try to work it out. We actually built a gym in our garage, and we worked out heavy, I mean every day, and I was seeing results. Unfortunately, the results that I was seeing wasn't what I wanted. The results I saw, I was liking the fact that I was losing weight. And I was losing a lot of weight, and it was good weight. However, I've had 3 children naturally. And with that, as a lot of ladies know, you do get basically skin issues from your stomach stretching and then going back to normal, then stretching, then going back to normal. That skin does not tighten back up, no matter how many weights I lifted, no matter how many crunches, sit-ups, planks, nothing worked to lift that skin. So I was constantly losing weight, but my skin was constantly sagging more. And I lost weight good. I'm going to try to insert some pictures of us working out and things of that nature. So when I started working out, I probably was like 205 pounds. I'm only 5 feet even, so that is very heavy for someone that is 5 feet. I didn't look like that's what I weighed, but that's what I weighed. After working out, I believe I got down to like 180 pounds, but I just didn't like it. I didn't like the extra skin. I didn't like where I was losing weight at. I'm naturally curvy. I like my hips, I like my behind, I like things, you know, I like those things about myself. I really love everything about myself, but it's room for improvement, and I wanted to make those improvements. I didn't like the way jeans would look, form-fitted dresses would look. You would see those love handles. I didn't like it. So I flirted with the idea of going out of town. My husband was like, no, we are in the middle of a pandemic, and that's not going to work for me. And I was like, okay, that makes sense. So then I started doing my research here. I also looked into my actual hospital that I go through. I go through Henry Ford Hospital here in Michigan. And I talked to some people that had surgery before me through some physicians and things of that nature. But their tummy tucks were nice, but it just wasn't for me. So then I started on Facebook getting in some of those groups, plastic surgery groups. And I messaged a young lady. I believe her name was Ashley, but I messaged a young lady. I was going to originally go to Dr. Samson. A lot of people have heard of him. Women that are considering plastic surgery, he's like supposedly the BBL king. I'm not looking for a BBL. Let me make that clear. I have a lot of booty. I'm not looking for a BBL. My natural butt is nice. So that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for these love handles to be gone, and I have extra stomach that just plain liposuction would not help someone like me. I'm not, it's not bad, and I'll stand up and I'll show you. It's not bad if you can see, but it is extra skin from having kids, and liposuction would eliminate this like pocket of fat here, but it would not get this, which is what I don't like, and this. I don't like this at all. So I am going to have the hourglass tummy tuck. The young lady, Ashley, was like, listen, you know, Dr. Samson is good, but he's having a lot of issues right now in the surgical world. You guys have someone there in Michigan called Dr. Michael Gray. So I looked him up on Facebook, added myself to the group, also on Instagram. And I just like what I've seen. I like what I've seen. He's very, very, very attentive. He answers all questions. He actually responds on his pages. Like, if you send him a private message, he will respond. That was amazing to me, because when you're looking for someone to work on you, you want to be sure that you can contact them if you have any type of issues that you don't understand. And, you know, everybody's body is different. That's another thing I want to get to. When you research people to look into these surgeries, everybody has something, whether it's people are complaining about getting some type of bacterial infection, or they have nerve damage. These things are common. I just want to put that out there. They're common. I'm looking for deaths. I'm looking for reoccurrences, like continuous reoccurrences, things of that, which Dr. Michael Gray does not have. He doesn't have. It was a lot of people saying, hey, he's not board certified surgeon, things of that, plastic surgeon, things of that nature. He is an actual surgeon. So I researched, and I'm just saying, do your research. You know, you don't have to listen to what other people are telling you. Of course, you want the insight from people, but look at the broad view, not just one and two people, because people are people. So anyway, that brings me back. So I am going to Dr. Michael Gray here in West Bloomfield, Michigan. And his work is amazing. Just look it up. You'll see for yourself. He has people all around seeking his expertise in his field. So I'm getting an hourglass tummy tuck, and I am getting liposuction to my back rolls, my hip, and my waist. Because like I said, I don't like my love handle. So I wanted to do whatever I can do to eliminate those. That's all I'm doing. I'm not doing a BBL. So if you're looking for BBL information, you got to research. This is not the video for that. But anyway, so I researched. I've talked to a lot of young ladies in the group, whom for the majority of people had nothing but good things to state. I got all my information that I needed, and then I made my consultation. When I called to do my consultation, my husband was like, hey, listen, this is who you're going to. So we went ahead and we made a down payment. The down payment was $2,000. That is 100% refundable. You can get that $2,000 back if at the point of time of your consultation, if you decide that this is not going to be for you. Anytime after that, you can receive a refund, but it will not be for the full amount. So I believe that I made my consultation in about August, almost September time. And I had my consultation, in October, actually. I'm sorry. No, I had my consultation November 19th. And, it was great. He was very attentive. He answered every question that I had. Of course, I had more questions after I left, but the questions that I needed answered, he answered. He explained everything. He told me exactly what I needed done. I had to then make a choice of what I could afford to get done. And the procedures that I told you about earlier is what I decided to get done. So, if you want to know pricing and things of that nature, maybe I'll do another video of that. But for this video, I'm not going to do that. I will say this, his tummy tuck and some of his other procedures, they all go on specials during different months or seasons. So the best bet is just to call. It's called Skin Deep Spa. Once again, in West Bloomfield, Michigan. So yeah, that was that part of that. And then once I did that, I decided that I was going to go ahead and go through with my surgery at the time of the point of time of consultation. Is then you'll receive all your information in the mail as far as your surgical instructions for like full suction or for his hourglass tummy tuck. From there, basically, I decided that I needed to create a list. I listened to some of the young ladies. I also called the office myself and received some information. I brought a few things, and this is basically what my video is about. My video is about getting yourself prepared for surgery. He requests that you do a hyperbaric treatment, which is basically like oxygen therapy. And I did call, and I scheduled that appointment for the day before my surgery. My surgery is February 26th. So it is Friday. Everybody, please say a prayer for me. I go in at 9 a.m. Friday, February 26th of 2021. And they called me yesterday, which was February 22nd, and let me know that information, as well as, you know, you need to shave. You have to shave all of your abdominal region and your pubic region. I will be getting a drain. He let me know that at the point of consultation. My drain will be in my right hip, and that will last for as long as it needs to. Usually most people have it in for approximately about 2 weeks, but like I said, it varies on your body and how you're draining. But anyway, so let's get started. Basically, from talking to the young ladies in the group, as well as talking to the office staff, these are the things that I decided to get. Once again, you have to do what's going to work for you. So just do your research. This is just informational as to what I'm going to get. Now, if you would like, please leave me a comment. Please subscribe. I am going to do videos as much as I can during my healing process. Up until whenever I'm released to go back to work, I will actually do a video about how that day goes as well. I am a postal carrier, so I physically carry mail. My job is very physical. So I will give you guys all that information. Please like and subscribe. That's the only way you're going to see these updates, just so you can prepare yourself for surgery. I will try to be as transparent as I can about the things I'm experiencing and what I am going through. So from talking to the young ladies at the office and talking to, I inbox a lot of people probably can attest to that. Hi ladies, already gray dolls. I got the information from them. Especially Susie Q, and she's on Facebook, as well as Olivia Smith. Olivia has just got her surgery. Susie Q, she was phenomenal. She gave me a walker for free. I was just in the group. I happened to ask, and she was like, listen, you can pick it up and you can have it. And I was like, really? She's like, yeah. So everything went through. I contacted her. I picked it up. Not only did I do that, but she was so real. She gave me so many supplies. She gave me gauze that already have the Vaseline on there. If you don't know, he asked that you keep your incision that will be going across your tummy with it Vaseline, so therefore it does not tear or rip or rupture your sutures when you're taking off your towel. If you don't know, you will have to have a towel on. I do have a towel here. It's best to get a beach towel because it's longer and it will go across your whole abdominal area, and you have to have it 4 inches thick. So I will be having that on across my stomach, and don't want that to catch on those stitches. They are dissolvable stitches at that too. So you will use the Vaseline to keep that moistened, to keep that lubricated. So anyway, so I have some things here of what I decided to get for surgery, to prepare me for surgery. The young ladies at the office, when I got my garment, and yes, I purchased my garment from the office. Why? Because I want to make sure that I'm getting the right thing. Amazon cannot physically talk to you and tell you this is the right garment for you. Now, they do have it. The young ladies are very, they know everybody has the situation. They let me know exactly what kind of garment that I can use and cannot use. This is my suggestion. I suggest you get your very first garment from Dr. Michael Gray's office, Skin Deep Spa. You just want to have the right stuff. You don't want to complicate your own healing process. You already went through the part where you paid all of this money. Why would you want to not heal properly? Why wouldn't you want to follow directions? Why would you not want to do everything you can do humanly possible to ensure that you're going to heal properly? Your body on itself is working, and you know, everybody's body is different. So you may, you know, occur some type of issues, prayerfully not, but you may. But on your end, you want to make sure you're doing everything that you can do to minimize you having any complications. At least I know I do. So anyway, with that being said, the garment I got, and then it's in this little cute little bag here that you get from the office, and I will show that in case anybody needs to know how to spell his name. You know, you see those credentials on the end of his name? You see that? Let me get a little closer. See the credentials? Exactly. Okay, so let's see. This is my garment that I did purchase from his office. It comes, see, there you go. And as you can see, it is very stretchy. See, this is what it looks like here. This is the back view. This here is the front view. See the zipper, and I'll unzip it for you. See, it has the hooks here just to keep everything in place. Can you see those hooks? There you go. But look how stretchy it is. You guys, you don't want anything super tight because you will kill your skin. He reiterated this so many times to me. If you put something super tight, you will kill your skin. You will have necrosis. You don't want that. It's loose for a reason. See? And then it also has a little hole that is in there so that you may use the restroom without taking it off if you choose to. A lot of people still take it off, but that's your choice, what you choose to do. But that's that. I also was told it's better to, you can just hand wash this, pop it in the dryer for a few minutes, and then put it right back on instead of running it through a whole wash cycle, which is going to take a long time. And if you were like me, I was balling on the budget, so I couldn't afford two of these. Once again, if you like and subscribe, I will do pricing over all of the items that I had to get through Skin Deep Spa, Dr. Michael Gray's office. But if not, then I won't waste you guys' time with that. So once again, that's the garment. And then from there, I will try to add the links on Amazon for the things that I did purchase through Amazon. And I got them all approved through Michael Gray's office. Because once again, you want to maximize your healing, not complicate it. So these I got through Amazon. And I'm not sure of the price. Once again, I will do pricing over all my items. I will also add the actual links in a separate YouTube video or a separate video for you guys to see all pricing and what I got. You can simply look this up now. You see the name on Amazon. These were approved. These are, as you can see, compression stockings. You have to have these. You have to have these. These minimize blood clots. You have to have these. They minimize blood clots. You don't want a blood clot. So these are necessary. And I believe he told me for at least the first week. But he'll let you know at your post-op appointment of where he thinks you're at and if you should keep them on. Follow his instructions. Follow the doctor's instructions. I plan to. Once again, I will do more videos, like and subscribe, so that you can see, you know, exactly what I'm going through, my healing process, things of that nature. I will show you. I will try to be as transparent as YouTube will allow me to be. But once again, these are the medical compression stockings. They were approved through the staff at Skin Deep Spa, Dr. Michael Gray's office. And that's that, the compression stockings. So also from Amazon, I got this abdominal binder. You have to have an abdominal binder. That's necessary. You have to have an abdominal binder. Once again, I will provide all the links to everything that I got. You see the name. You can simply type it in your Amazon. But if you want the exact link, I will provide that in a separate video. That will be all about pricing, all of, with all of the links for everything that I purchased. This is an abdominal binder. I have two of these. I have two of these. And I have 1,000 towels. So that I'll be able to change what I have going on. Also, at Skin Deep Spa, when I got my my garment that I will need, they told me there that I will need some thick socks. Because, like most surgical hospitals or surgical facilities, they're cold. If you've ever been in a hospital, you know it's cold. So the young ladies let me know that up front, it's cold. Come in with my socks. Thick socks. So, got my thick socks. They actually have little ridges, so hopefully I don't fall. I don't want to fall. So I have those. Also on Amazon, I purchased bromelain. You can also get this in pineapple, and I do have pineapple juice as well, 100% pineapple juice. But this is the best way to get all that you need through the tablets. You'll probably be drinking a million juices to try to get this bromelain. Bromelain is good for minimizing your swelling. So, bromelain. I did get Arnicare tablets. As you can see, it says pain relief. It also minimizes swelling. I have the tablets. I have the gel as well. All of these things were purchased through Amazon. It was just easy for me. Also, for reduce swelling, I have Arnica tea. I love tea, so I will be drinking this during the whole healing process. I can't eat anything or drink anything 10 hours prior to my surgery, so I won't be drinking this before. But I will be drinking this probably immediately after. I will also have some chicken broth. Soon as I'm done my surgery, my husband's going to have my chicken broth ready for me. I will be drinking that because with the pain pills, I do hear that if you do not eat, you will be nauseous. Well, you guys, we're having muscle repair. So you're going to be extremely tight. So things like coughing is going to hurt, but it's necessary. He does instruct you that you need to cough at least every 15 minutes. You also need to walk at least every 15 minutes after your surgery or post-surgery. So I will be doing my coughs with my walking, as well as I have like a little pillow. So he says that it's easier to cough into a pillow to relieve that tension that you will have. They said sneezing, coughing, throwing up, vomiting, rather. Those type of things do hurt. So you have to brace yourself. But like I said, I'm going to go through with this. Oh, by the way, not only is the muscle pair included with your abdominal tummy tuck, I also have a hernia. That brings me back to my decision to having this done as well. I have a hernia. I was going to have to get that repaired eventually. Anyway, Dr. Michael Gray fixes hernias for no additional cost. What you pay for your hourglass tummy tuck, you will get muscle repair. If you have any hernias, he will address those issues as well. He will also, if he can see them, he will let you know that during your consultation. He let me know that during my consultation because he did see that prior to doing any surgery or working on me. And he let me know that. So I will be getting that fixed as well. Brings me back to the things that I got. I also have these for hydration to put into my water. Liquid IV. I will be using this liquid IV. Once again, this is just something I will be doing. This is not necessary. But I purchased this through Amazon, liquid IV. I will be doing this for, you know, just getting my fluids back up after surgery. You're going to lose fluids. That's just, it's common. That's something that just happens with that. You are going to need rolled gauze. I hear that, you know, you should put this in your belly button, in your navel, you know, after you first have your surgery. Also, it will go around my incision. You also can use poise pads. You can use any type of pads, but I hear poise pads work best for any type of leakage as far as your liposuction, as well as to protect your incision, just to give you a little bit more comfort with your incision as well. Poise pads. Acid reflux is very common with any type of like bariatric surgery as well as tummy tucks and things of that nature. So I have these. This is just a CVS brand. You can use Pepcid, AC, things of that nature, but I have an acid controller to hopefully help with acid reflux or heartburn, things of that nature. Your throat, a lot of people say your throat really hurts. So after post-surgery, so I have a lot of lozenges, lots of lozenges. This one has melatonin in it just because I like to sleep. Hey, sleeping is good after you have any type of surgical procedure because sleeping is basically, it helps the body to heal. Sleeping is essential. Melatonin is essential for me. So these come with melatonin. I do just have, I have a lot of regular cough drops as well. I've really stocked up on cough drops. In case my throat is sore from the tube, you know, going down your throat to do surgery, I have this. I will be using this as well. Oh, and Vicks. I can't leave home without my Vicks. So I will be using my Vicks. Vicks Vapor Rub. I am country. I live up north, but I am country. So at heart, I'm going to use my Vicks. Also, this is for the drains. You can look this up. It was on YouTube. It will hold the drains. Now that he uses one, when I started, it was more common for him to use two drains. So I did get this to hold both drains. Once again, I'm only having one drain, so I don't even know if I really will be using this. But this will come in one of my post-op videos. I will share if I use it or not. I also have a urinal. And a lot of young ladies say those don't really help. I will let you know. I will also include that in my post-op video if I'm going to use the urinal or not. Right now, I do have it, but I don't know if I'm going to use it. I have Miralax. Let's talk about that. Constipation. He could not say that enough times. The young ladies in the group cannot say that enough time. You do not want to get constipated. You do not want to get constipated. You do not want to get constipated. They say it hurts really, really, really bad. The surgery itself, most young ladies say they were not in any physical pain, really bad pain. Most just say it's really tight. You're really tight. And so it creates discomfort. Anytime that you're not used to doing things that you are used of normally doing is discomfort. So you will go through discomfort. They say it's not too much pain. I will let you know. I'm going to include that on my video. So I will let you know. So anyway, back to constipation. I have Smooth Move tea. I also will be drinking this. Smooth Move. Move those bowels. As well as my Miralax. To help me drain a little better. A lot of young ladies say the lymphatic drain drops. These lymphatic drops help tremendously to help your fluids to flow. Therefore, you can get rid of that drain a little faster. And then once again, I have the Vaseline that I'm going to use over my incisions. They say do not use anything in your belly button. Nothing. Nothing at all. Don't use anything in your belly button. That's what I was told. That's what I'm going to do. I will let you know how that works for me in the post-op video. And then this is just some tape to hold my gauze. You'll need some tape. You'll need some a gauze tape. So that's what this is, or paper tape is what they call it. I will be using this paper tape here with my gauze. Here, this is antibacterial gauze to hold it. When you go get fitted for your garment, they will have a sheet similar to this. And it just says, and as you can see, these are my measurements. I will do a post-op video to let you know where my measurements will be. I hope that I answered most things. Can put you at ease. Oh. The day of surgery. The day of surgery, what I will wear. I will wear, I have some really big drawstring, like pajama bottoms. I will wear that in there. I brought a muumuu. It's called a muumuu. Basically, that's like a house gown, but it zips up from the front. They say you should get something that just, it's easy for the nurses to put you into your clothes. It's easy on you if it's easy on them. We want to make this as easy as possible, people. So I have something that zips up. A muumuu is what most people call them. But if you don't know what that means, it's just a gown. That's all it is. It's a gown. It's a nightgown, basically. So it zips up from the front. They say either get zips or buttons. Zips are obviously easier than buttons, but get something that zips up. No undergarments, so you don't wear your bra. You don't wear your underwear because for what? They're going to have to take them off anyway. So, yep. So when you go to your surgery, when you're about to have your surgery and you go, all they want you to wear is your compression stockings and your socks. That's it. Everything else you're going to have to take off. So I'm going to have my robe because it's February. I live in Michigan. It's cold outside. I don't believe that I will need a big coat. I do have a heavy robe, so I'll be bringing my robe. I'll have my husband bring that in. I hope that this video helped. Once again, I will do a post-op video. I will do several post-op videos for you guys. I hope that everybody has a smooth surgery. Pray for me. Once again, my surgery is February 26th, which is Friday coming up. Say a prayer for me. My stats are I'm 5 feet even. That's funny. Because when I started working out, I was 205 pounds. I had got down to 180, 179 pounds. Well, guess what? Dr. Michael Gray said, listen, don't diet. Don't do it. My husband said, you might as well enjoy it. That girl then went back up to 200 pounds. 200 pounds. I was just 5 feet. A lot of young ladies in the group say that. Don't worry about that. You can't eat. You can't eat much of nothing. So hopefully I'll be right back down. I would like to be around about 165. Like I said, I enjoy being curvy. So I don't really want to be a toothpick. But I'll show you guys for the record. This is where I'm at. Hopefully you can see. This is me. This is all me. This is me. That's me. Yep. See, that's my back rolls. I'll get that handled. That's me. So, yep. 5 feet, 200 pounds to be continued. Have a blessed day. Future Gray Doll. Peace. So you will also need a reclining chair, preferably a lift reclining chair. A lot of people also just use their couch with the like wedge pillows on there, but do not use your bed. Absolutely do not. He does not recommend that. He does not want you to do that. It's too difficult to get in and out of, and you will rupture your sutures, which he does not want you to do. A reclining lift chair is best. We rented ours from Benson's. The reason we went through Benson's is because I'm just not fond of Rent-A-Center. To each his own. That Rent-A-Center does rent them out. Once again, we went to Benson's medical supply store. And it was really easy. We went there, told them what we needed. They let us try them out. I was able to sit in the actual chair. They were all clean, sanitized. You cannot rent from the section that is not sanitized. So they were clean, sanitized. They let us sit in them, try it out. If this is what you want, cool. So I did that, tried it out, decided that I wanted a black leather one. So I got a black leather lift reclining chair. A lot of young ladies in the group say you will also want like a toilet seat riser, for the toilet. I didn't get that. I guess I'll let you know how I got on and off the toilet. My sister, I will be staying with my sister-in-law because I have little small children. They're not going to understand. They can't jump on mommy. We're kind of affectionate. So they're used to jumping on me and kissing on me, and they're not going to understand that. So me and my husband decided that it's best that I would stay, you know, where I'm going to stay, which she literally stays around the corner from Dr. Michael Gray's office anyway. So it's just convenient that way. So a lift recliner is necessary in my book. I will be getting a lift recliner. I won't be getting a toilet seat riser, but I do hear that is pretty essential as well. I'm going to try to thug it out. I'll let y'all know in the next video if I really needed it. What else was it? I think that's it. If not, I will add that again. Okay, for real. I'm gone. Peace, love, and soul.